Hello, you Morphin Power Rangers! Ralphie here with Whiskey Review 279, Ochintoshin Valanche. And thank you to Jonas Bratelli for that malt mention. Jonas, your patience has finally been rewarded. My suggestion to you now is that you reward yourself with a substantial glass of good quality whiskey and take your time with it, Jonas. Enjoy every drop, just as anybody who buys this will be enjoying every drop. It's a cracker of a whiskey, very contemporary, very much of the moment. It is an Ochintoshin Valanche. What's a valanche? The valanche is that pipe that they use for siphoning spirit out of casks. It's like a copper pipe with a wee hole at the bottom where the whiskey goes in and a wee hole at the top that you put your thumb over to create a vacuum to hold that whiskey in while you raise the valanche up and pour some into your glass, but not too much, because invariably if you pour too much you're going to spill it, and that would be a terrible waste. Now I'm going to do something a little bit different here, because many of you whiskey drinkers do not necessarily have a Glencairn glass, and you may feel that you're getting a significantly less whiskey experience because you're using a standard wine goblet. Don't worry too much about it. With a different glass, you basically slightly change your style of nosing. You don't have to worry about the tasting, it's the nosing. This Ochintoshin, it's a young one. It's bottled at 57.5%, so it's cask strength, and that means that unless you're one of these unimaginative old traditionalists who absolutely swear blind that you should never add water to whiskey, which as far as I'm concerned is fine. If you just want your tongue anaesthetised with alcohol, go for it. If you're not that interested in tasting the whiskey, go for it. But for those of us who want to taste the whiskey without the anaesthetic nip of the alcohol, well, we are going to do just exactly what the master blenders in the whiskey industry do. We're going to add water to bring it down and make it palatable. Importantly, when you add water to a cask strength whiskey, it weakens the influence of the alcohol in retaining all these thousands of chemicals that make up the flavour, and in releasing them into the water which has been added, it makes the whole experience much more substantial and palatable. There you have it. So I'm going to add some water. It's a young, light bourbon matured whiskey, not a lot of sherry going on here, a lot of fresh bourbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 great big plenty splashes of water in that. It's, my goodness, practically doubled the volume, but it's just like Aberlour Abana. This whiskey can take a lot of water and benefits from it. Ochintoshin, a Lowland whisky. The old dogma says that Lowland whiskies are light whiskies. Now what they really mean is they're light in style. They're fruity, they're fresh, they've got a kind of zestiness about them. Rosebank certainly does, as does Bladnach, but there's nothing light about the flavour. The flavour can be as big and as substantial as any beefy mortlach. This whiskey I recommend for an experienced whiskey drinker. So you've got back past the beginner stage and you're looking for a profound quality bourbon matured whiskey experienced for your more experienced palate. Maybe you've been drinking malts and blends for a couple of years now, but you're not really wanting to put your hands too deep into your pockets for these rare old single cask whiskies, which can be pretty variable in terms of quality, believe you me. But this creamy, zesty apricot, double cream brulee, banana, sherbet, lovely sherbet in the nose, lemon puffs, soft grapefruit and melon, Chantilly melon. sweet floral shrub rose. You get that sweet, sickly smell from old style Bourbon and Rugosa roses, which you'll find in Victorian gardens across Europe, and you certainly have this here. Very nice indeed. The addition of water introduces, after about 10-15 minutes, it really changes the character of this whiskey in quite a significant degree, and there's such an education in this glass. But becomes dustier. There's more of a fresh, warm summer straw note comes through in the nose. It becomes aromatic with hints of rose water, Turkish delight, some mild ginger and lemon curd. Taste. Sweet and sour lemon. If you ever go to Italy, look out for limoncello. It's a lemon liqueur, sweetened lemon liqueur, that you can buy down the Amalfi coast. And if you are in Amalfi itself, outside of the St Andrew's Church, the nuns set up a little stall selling their limoncello, and the nuns make the best limoncello on the Amalfi coast. Believe you me, they really know what they're doing. They take the time and they do a fantastic job, far better than the more commercial stuff. Rice wine, raisin, vanilla, buttercream, icing sugar, that lemon note coming in again, butterscotch, some soft spices, some nutmeg, some coriander, maple, honey, vanilla, and the finish, you have a mild, gentle little white pepper note, honey, vanilla, and wood dust. And I mean nice wood dust, not nasty wood dust. There is a lovely complexity in the finish of this whiskey. Now you notice I'm not using a Glencairn glass here. I'm using a Paris goblet, because for many of you who can't get Glencairn glasses, you may be saying, am I just getting an inferior experience by using an ordinary wine glass? No, you're not. What you've got to do is, it's a little bit tougher for you. You've got a wider rim here, you see, in this glass compared to a Glencairn. So what you've got to do is you've got to get your nose further into the glass and move the glass around your nose in order to pick up the subtleties of the smell. Lovely. Beautifully fresh, and it's proof, very clear evidence, a wee touch of yeastiness coming in there now, that young whiskies don't have to be bad whiskies. Some young whiskies can be very good. Old Pulteney do a very good young whisky, because the nature of their spirit as it comes off the still means that it can be very successful as a young spirit. But there's a lot of distillers out there who are just bottling young spirit to get the profits in. The quality's not that great. And I'll be reviewing some of them. They're not bad, bad whiskies, but, you know, they're a bit, you're getting a bit short-changed in the bottle. But certainly not with this Auchentoshan Valanche. This gets 90 points out of 100. And that is a malt mark. Oh yes, it is. My concluding notes in this this excellent bottling is that over time in the glass for a young whiskey, it's amazing how it will mellow and soften up, and you'll get more puff candy, fudgy notes and soft lemons coming through. The citrus will diminish. It migrates from citrus into a floral grain note, which is quite interesting and subtle, very delicate. It's an excellent example of a quality young finish, very contemporary, and a heavy flavour, a big full flavour for what is generally regarded to be a light whisky. It's Ralphie recommended, and Ralphie recommends that you return again. Return to Whiskey Review, what is it? Yeah, 280. where I'll be reviewing the Glendronic original. Join me then for more Malty Moments. See you soon.